Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. In this week's sewing class we're gonna make something out of this beautiful jersey, and the regular viewers know that I'm always making something out of white or soft pink or beige or something, so I really try to put some more color into my projects. And you certainly have seen that for the next seasons, spring and summer, the bold bigger pattern tropical floral patterns are very on trend, and I find this beautiful one. It's a jersey, it's a viscose jersey, so very stretchy, and we're gonna make a four panel skirt out of it. And that means that you get on the bottom, on the hem, the width like a circle skirt, but not the problems of a circle skirt, and I show you how that is. And the nice thing is you can make it as wide or as small as you like on the hem. Instead of a circle skirt, you always have that whole circle on the hemline, and sometimes that is not really that nice. So we're gonna make a four panel skirt. And if you like this kind of videos, please subscribe to my channel, and you will get every week new videos and new sewing classes with free patterns. So thank you so much if you like to subscribe. So I screenshotted some floral skirts that I saw on ASOS, H&M, Misguided, Zara. I'm sure you have seen them all also everywhere, and there are lots and lots of midi skirts or maxi skirts, and most of them have slits, so I like that look very much. So we're gonna recreate one of these, and I'll show you in my drawing how it will be the skirt that we are going to make. So this is the drawing, and for people that are new here, I cannot draw at all, I know that, but it doesn't matter. That doesn't mean that you cannot design and that you cannot sew, because my drawings are just a reminder for me what I want to make and how I want to make it. So I put the details in my drawing, or sometimes I make notes next to it to remind me how I want to make something. And what we're gonna make is a four panel skirt. So that means we have a front panel, a back panel, and two side panels. And in between those panels we make slits. And of course you can make the slits as high as you like. I make my length a midi skirt, but you can make it shorter or longer, whatever you like. And then measure till where you want your slits to be. And I make the slits on all the seams where the panels are connecting. So you get 1, 2, 3, 4 slits. Then I make an attached waistband that has elastic inside. But I just use the elastic to hold the shape of the fabric, because we have jersey, this, so that is stretchy. And I hope that I can get in and out without using a zipper. And then the elastic in the waistband, just make sure that the waistband isn't stretching too much when you try it on and off and put it on and off all the time. Usually your fabric will just stretch out a little bit and then your waist will be too wide. So I just put the elastic in for that, but it's not scrunched in here at the waistband. It's just to keep the shape. If my fabric, or if your fabric, is not stretchy enough to get in and out, you can just put a zipper here on one of the seams, or even here on the mid-back if you like, and then just put a zipper in and a button here on your waistband, and then it's easier to get in and out. But I'm gonna try if I can do it without, and I will leave down below the tutorial that I already did of how to make a zipper in a seam or in a skirt. So if you cannot get, if I can get in and out but you can't, then you can watch that tutorial how you can make a zipper here and finish this skirt the way you need it to. So that will be the skirt, and I'll show you how to make the pattern. So what you will need to make your pattern are your body measurements, and if you don't have them yet, I will link down below my tutorial how you can take your own measurements and put that in a chart like this, so that you can use it over and over again if you need to make a new pattern. You usually can just use your basic patterns and make adjustments, but if you have to make a new pattern, then it's very nice to have your measurements on hand. Also, when you want to buy something online or something, then you don't have to measure yourself every time again. So do that first, that you have these measurements in the chart. Then what you do is you take a piece of paper that is doubled. So this is doubled up with the fold here. And then you mark with your chart, you mark out on the top your 1/8 of a waist. And in your chart you have put down a quarter of your waist. Now you need a 1/8 of the waist length and you mark that down. Then on your hip height, you mark down from, of course, from the fold, your hip width. And then what you do, I want my panels to be the width of my fabric. And that means in my country, the fabrics are always 150 meters wide. So doubled up, here is the fold. It is 75 centimeters and I want to make my panel on the bottom 75 centimeters. But now that I have doubled it up, this will be half 75 centimeters. And then what you do is you mark that width of the 75 centimeters divided by 2. And then you put a straight line from your waist going through the hips. If your hips are wider than mine, mine are here, so my hip width is smaller than the pattern that I want to make. So that is okay. If your hips are wider, you must take that width first and then go down. But I could just follow it to the end of my skirt, the length of my skirt. And on that length, I marked the half of my 75 centimeters width. And just draw a straight line going down. Then I don't remember how long I made this. Let's measure it. This is 75 centimeters. Then what you do, because this is a diagonal line, this is longer. So you measure out here, going here, going here, going here, that everywhere it is that same 75 centimeters here. So you get a sort of a curved hemline, so that the hem is everywhere the same length. Otherwise here on the edge, it would be longer and that's not what we want. So make sure that it's all everywhere the same. And what I also always do is take a little bit off the waistline here on the middle where the fold is. So I took half a centimeter down so that you here also get a little bit of a curve and that makes that it sits more nicely in the waist. You don't really have to do it, but if you give just half a centimeter down here in the middle, then you get a more nice curve there. And as I said, if your hip width is wider, of course make it wider. And maybe then you don't get a straight line to the end, then just give it a bit in. Or make your skirt shorter, but you need that width there. Then what you do is you cut it out and open it up. Then you have your whole pattern. And as I said, I want to make each part 75 centimeters, but I'm not sure if that will look good on me because I'm very short, I'm 5'2", and maybe that will be really too wide because this is a jersey, so it's a water thick fabric. It's not a viscose or a chiffon or something, so I'm not sure if that will look good on me, but I really want to try to make it as wide as I can. So I'm just gonna start with 75 centimeters at the hemline for each panel. If it's too much, I will just take it off and I'll just make my line like this or just as much as I have to take off to make it nicely looking. So I'm just gonna start wide. And then what you do is you cut it out with seam allowance, of course. And the nice thing is, this is my doubled fabric of the fold here. I could just cut it out, then I have two panels, put it on the other side of the fabric, and then I have two panels more, and then we've cut out all our pieces. So then the sewing part is very easy, and we start with finishing all the vertical lines. So all these long lines of all the four parts for the four panels. And just do that separately, so each panel the side seams. Now mark on each panel where you want your slit to end, so I put a pin here. And then you put two pieces on top of each other and you pin that down till the slit. I made mine 44 centimeters from the top. Sorry. And then you sew them down. And watch carefully that you don't sew here and here, because I started to pin this side too. But because these are not side seams, it's just two panels connecting. So the next panel is gonna go on top of this one, on top of this one, and you make a circle out of them. So don't sew two sides together, then you have a problem. You open this up, iron that down, put another pin on this part, pin that down till the slit, and then go so on till you have all four panels together in one circle. So I saw all my seams and I ironed them open, and I was very happy that I could take all this width that I wanted on the bottom. It looked really nice. The only thing I did, I made my slits a little bit farther up open because it was a little weird piece, as if I hadn't sewn it down right. So I made it a little bit open, with this fabric, it's a jersey knit. When you use your seam ripper, you very easily get holes, so I always use a razor blade, and with that I mean just a really razor blade, a very old-fashioned one, but it's very good to use for sewing projects. I have the Gillette ones, because then you can securely open up your seams without ripping your fabric. You have to be very careful, but it's easier to do than with a seam ripper. So if you need to do something like that, I would advise that. Then I could very easily go in the top. I even was thinking about taking it in a little bit, but I thought, no, it's okay like this. I'll just make my waistband with the elastic, and then maybe it will cinch in a little bit, because we made the curve of the waistline a little bit, made a little bit of a curve on the waistline. It gets more, a little bit more wide, but especially a little bit more stretchy. So it was way too much for me, but I'll leave it like this. So I cut my waistband. I had to do it in two pieces, so I sewed them together there. That has the length of your waist, so measure the waist of your skirt. And I made mine 4 inches doubled, so that is with seam allowance, because my elastic is 3 centimeters. So what I'll do, I'll make a circle out of this by sewing the ends together too, but just halfway, because I will need a hole to get my elastic in. So just sew one of the halves till the middle, and then do a good backstitch. Later on we will sew down the rest of it when we have put our elastic in. And then you've done that, you turn. Well, I'll do it like this. I like that very much with this kind of fabric. I will just put them right sides together, and then I will place them to the right side of the skirt. And you can choose whether you want your seams to be at another seam where you attach the panels, or whether you want it in the mid back or to the side, because I have two. I will to the side, so that is the middle of the panels on the side. And then you just pin it like this, sew it on. Make sure you use a straight stitch or a zigzag stitch, otherwise it will pop immediately when you try it on the first time. And then you give it a good zigzag stitch, so that will stay stretchy too. Usually I almost always use my serger, but a serger stitch is not stretchy, so I won't do that now. I will just use a straight stitch and a zigzag stitch to attach these together. So you do the doubled waist band on the skirt. And when you cut your waistband, make sure it is stretchy, because my fabric is four-way stretch, so I had to put it all in one another angle than I cut my skirt. But that's not a problem, because it will be stretchy every way I put it. But when you have just a two-way stretch, then make sure that your waistband has the stretch in the length, otherwise you will have a problem getting in. thing left to do now is hem the slit sides. And you do that by best by just first iron it in, then pin it and top stitch it. And of course hemming the bottom. And what I will do is I will use my twin needle to hem the bottom, the hemline. What you get then is on the right side you get a double stitching. And on the wrong side you get a zigzag. And that means that you can finish this edge first with a zigzag stitch or an overlocker. And then fold it in and use your twin needle. But because you get a zigzag on the wrong side, you can also leave it just like this. This won't fray, so that problem you don't have. But because you get a zigzag, you already also finishes the inside of your hem, the edge of your hem. So I'm gonna use that. The only thing that is not nice is you need two cones of the same color of thread. And that often is a problem for me because I have lots of colors but not two of each color. But what you can do is just make some threads onto a bobbin and use that as your second cone to sew that down. And I hear often that very many people have problems with sewing with a twin needle. I never had. I use it a lot and I've never had any problems. I hope I will get now for the first time. But I really like it. Just watch your settings on your thread, your bobbin and your upper thread. That is okay. Make a trying on just the scrap that you have left of the fabric you are using and see how it goes. It's, as I said, I never had problems before, so I will use it now certainly. But if you do, just try it again because it's really a nice way of hemming your skirt or your garment when it's made out of jersey or out of knit. So try it and hopefully you will succeed. Here is the skirt and it's really nice and wide. I was really happy that I could use the whole width that I wanted because now the hemline is 3 meters all around, so that's really a lot. And I like the slits. That's also a thing that you cannot do when you make a silk skirt. Then you have your circle and of course you can make slits in, but it's really tough to do. And this was very easy and we have slits in the front, slits in the back. A nice tight waistline that I really like because I don't really like it when this is all scrunched up, especially with this fabric because it's a jersey, a viscose jersey, and a viscose jersey is a bit lighter than a polyester jersey or a cotton jersey. But still, when you scrunch this up with an elastic waistband, you get a lot of fabric here and I don't really like it. I like when it's more a bit sleek here, and now the elastic is just here to keep it in shape. It's a little bit scrunched in, but not really that much. And it's really nice and flowy, and I really like the pattern, and you know that I like florals, but this for me is a rather dark one, but I think it's really nice and I just have to get used to the green color, the darker color, that is not a white of a pink, but I think it's really nice and it's very nice to wear. Also very easy to travel with because it doesn't wrinkle. I haven't ironed it except for the seams, and when you see the inside, because it is printed so the inside is white, you see that it has a lot of wrinkles, but because you don't see it on the outside, I thought, well, I'm not gonna iron it. It's okay like this, and it looks really, really nice, I think. So the four panel skirt is very simple to do. You saw it's very easy to make, but your outcome is really nice. And I like this more than a circle skirt, as I already mentioned a few times, because of the outcome and because how easy it is to make. And also hemming is way more easy than a circle skirt because you then have to hem in a circle, in a curve, and it is not always that simple. I know it was very nice. As you saw, I used my twin needle for hemming the bottom part, for hemming the hemline. And I think I found out what the problem is for most people, that they don't like it. Normally I use a twin needle that is 2.5 centimeters the two apart. Now I use the 4 millimeters twin needle. And then I saw that my bobbin thread was a bit too tight. And when you do that, when you have that, the two rows of your stitching will scrunch up a bit and you get a bump in between. And that doesn't look nice. And that, I think that's the problem that many people have with a twin needle. But you can easily adjust that by just putting your bobbin thread a little bit less tight. And for me, I have a screw on my bobbin, what's that called? Chamber? I don't know what it's called. I have a screw on top of it, and when you just give it a quarter to the looser side, so to the left, then your problem is solved. You get nice two rows of stitching on the good part and a zigzag on the wrong part. And then it's not a problem at all. But don't forget when you are finished to put the bobbin thread back again to this normal setting, because otherwise your other project will have a too loose bobbin thread. So that can be the problem if you have that problem too. As I said, I never have problems with twin needles. I really love them. I hope you like this tutorial. Next week we have another tutorial and it will be a very special one, so don't miss out on that one. And thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe if you haven't done already. And I'll see you again next week. Bye!